Right, so in this lesson we are going to make the nut and the pieces for connecting, which is here. We will connect, we will make this part, and some nuts which we will connect the handle for this connector or this support. Let's go get started by going to our reference, and we start from a circle. So we'll start from a circle, and in the center it will be a radius of 4, not 4. So we want two circles. The first circle will be a radius of 2, and another circle with a radius of 6. So we have make two diameters, one diameter of 6 and one diameter of 4, and this will be our reference. So we will go straight for making push and pull, and go for 3 steps. So the first step will be 7.5, and the second step will be 7.5, and again we will go another push and pull for around 5. And I will copy the reference which will be here. So we can copy this one from the center to around this distance. And again, we will push this for a distance of 10, I think. For here, and again we will right. So we are now done here for this part. I will select all these objects, select this object, and go and move to the object, and select this main part and go to the object. And after that I will select all these three objects and go to union object and some objects here. So we have this one piece, and again we want to mirror. So I will mirror, select this object and mirror from this axis to also to this axis, right. So we will mirror from the center After that, I will rotate it to match this, and then we can combine these two. Alright, so we are now done for this part, and I will combine these two into one object by using the union. So these are two objects, and let's see what we have. We have one object, and we have this one, which we can move in some axes. And I think we have this one, which is a duplicate. Alright, so in the top view, I will move this axis. I will move this bolt to some area here. So let's move again. And to deactivate also, and I will place to this center. Let's see what we have. So already we have this one, but this bolt was made for another geometry, so we will go for from the top. We will move again from this base point to this base point, and let's see if it, so it's already, if you go to the wireframe, we have this in place correctly as you see. And after that, we will copy this one. We are in the top view, and I will copy from this one to be here, and copy to the center again, and copy to the center. So already we have these four, and we should move this in place. So move from this one to this center. We have the 3D move and base point, which is here, and move for a 2B6 in this direction. And here we will pick a point, pick the center to be in the center, and we can move around 6 in this direction. Right, we have make these parts, so let's go to make another element. So I will go for the top and another thing we will make. We will make a line starting from this point, to be in the orso, and we will make it and I will offset by a distance of 10, and this distance will be here. And again we will make an arch, so we will go to the draw and make an arch from here. So we have the arch, we will select this one, and again this one. We will select two points, this one, and after that I will trim, and again we will make a circle. This circle will from here, and as usual the radius will be a radius of 2. And again, we will make the same here, or you can mirror. So I will make a circle here, and radius of 2. And I think we will select the push pull and select this area and push pull to be 4 millimeter. So now it's the time we have this one. So I will copy from this area to a distance which is here. And after that, we can move this one to be in place. So I will select from this one and start so this item will connect from here to here. So I will move from this point to this point. And again, we can rotate object here and this point here. And the angle will be an angle such as this, maybe angle of 30. Right, so now I will move this to match the same center from here. I will move in this axis from here to this. And again, we can rotate from here, and we will rotate until it matches this location. I think now we are done for this part. I will only move this object which I don't need. And in the next part, we will make the basic part which is inside the element here. And we can make the shaft which is, or the cylinder connector which is here.